Hello. So you might be thinking, why does her voice sound that way? But if you guys watched my vlog last week, you know I've been terribly ill and I have not been able to record anything. But I still wanted to do a video tomorrow, so I'm gonna keep it nice and short just so you don't have to bear with me listening to my voice for too long, because I know it's probably horrifically annoying. So bear with me and I won't babble on for too long. But something has been on my mind a little bit recently when it comes to reading and the way that I have sort of been consuming books and stories, my enjoyment level based on how I have been doing just that, the longevity of the way stories are sticking with me, the way that I hold on to certain books and not others, the way I choose to read books, all of these factors absolutely affect my ratings, feelings, enjoyment, impression, everything of a book. And I talk quite frequently on the channel about how something that genuinely makes me sad in life is the fact that I want to read so many books and experience so many stories, and I'll never have the time to get to all of the books I want to read, and I constantly feel behind. And this is not anything to do with BookTube or the BookTurnet or the internet, period. It's just simply, I want to read so many stories. And especially as my tastes are ever changing and ever evolving, the TBR just gets bigger and bigger and grows and becomes larger. And so I am continuously fighting this battle of getting to read all the books I want to read and trying to make that happen. And so what I tend to do is force myself to read all the time. It's not like it's a punishment, but I don't allow myself to do a lot of other hobbies that I really enjoy, because I know there's so many books I want to get to. And I don't want to keep doing that for the rest of my life. Another thing I make myself do is I like read as fast as I can, not speed reading and not skim reading, but reading as fast as I can, because I know that if I finish the book quickly, then I can move on to the next story. However, lately I've come to realize that these reading habits don't allow me to appreciate books as much as I used to when I took my time reading them a bit more. And this is no judgment or evaluation of anyone other than myself. So please keep that in mind as I'm talking about this today. So I wanna do a little experiment, and it's funny because my friend Joanna, I'll link her channel in her video below, because she sort of did the opposite reading experiment, because she tends to read like more just one thing at a time to truly appreciate and enjoy it. And she tried reading multiple things at once and it didn't work as well for her. And so what I wanna do is do this experiment of reading less and less at once. So primarily I feel like I will still listen to one audiobook and I will read one book physically. I've sort of already began this experiment in the month of October and it's going splendidly. I'm having a great time reading again and things are sticking with me. It doesn't mean every book's a favorite at all, but I just feel so much less pressure. So I guess in this experiment, I'm setting a goal of probably reading about 6 books per month, rather than, if you look at my statistics for the last couple of years, it would probably range from 9 or 10 to 18 books per month. And that includes novellas and short stories, things like that too. That's a lot of things to read and comprehend and keep track of and enjoy. So by limiting the number of books I'm putting on my TBR, even if I do read more than those 6 books, it will put less pressure on myself to check off all these books on my TBR. And I already feel so much less pressure to make myself read every day. Sometimes right now there's days on the weekend where I don't even have time to pick up a book, period, like at all. And previously for me to go a day without reading is insanity, and now I'm just allowing myself to do it. So goal number one, less books on the TBR to feel less pressure. Goal number two in the experiment is to basically only have 2 books going at once Three maximum. And the reason that I say three maximum is because I have started my reread of the Dune Chronicles by Frank Herbert. And I do have intentions to continue on with the series and annotate the entire six books in the original Dune Chronicles. And that's going to be a very slow background process. And I'm not going to rush my way through it. And I'm not going to make that my main read. So those books will sort of be in the background, and that's why I say three. Otherwise, I only want to have one physical book and one audiobook pretty much at all times. That is the second goal in this experiment. The third is don't force the honey. It's not worth it. So if I'm tired and I feel like watching a TV show, or I feel like sitting in the dark or doing a puzzle and not listening, or I want to go for a drive or be in the shower dancing, listening to music rather than an audiobook, I'm gonna give myself that freedom. As I said, I already started this experiment at the beginning of October, and allowing myself to do these things has brought so much more joy to my life. And I know this sounds so stupid because no one was forcing me to read more or to listen to more audiobooks other than myself, but just letting myself have that little bit of freedom to not feel so trapped into reading all the time has brought me back so much more joy when I do read and do have time to sit down and read. Anything when you force it is less fun. Reading is a hobby for me. It's not my job. I have a full-time job. Sometimes people are surprised to hear me say that. If you're new around here, I'm a full-time dental hygienist. YouTube is not my job. Reading is not my job. And so it is my favorite pastime, and I love to do it, but I don't only love to do it. So I'm really hoping that by sort of stepping back and taking the pressure off of myself, that it allows me to have more enjoyment from other areas in my life, and at the same time brings a little bit more joy back to reading, and I can already see that happening. So those are the three main things, I think. So going back to some of the reasons why I want to do this is I feel like books don't stick with me very much, and I do have memory issues in general. And so I don't know if it's more so associated with that, or I'm just not allowing myself to sit with a book long enough to process it and hold on to actually the information that I was meant to understand. But I do know that the longer I sit with a book and spend with a book, the more that it's ingrained in my memory, and I sit and ponder and I think about the things for longer. So as my reading tastes are changing and I gravitate more towards literary fiction or classics or really thematically heavy books that require a lot of additional thinking outside of the time of reading, I can't read as many books. And I would use the example right now, I'm reading The Count of Monte Cristo and I am reading 100 Years of Solitude. One is my audiobook and the other is my physical book. If I wasn't reading outside of the actual book itself about these texts, I wouldn't be enjoying them nearly as much. I use Spark Notes a lot, or just read summaries or what other people have had to say so that I can understand if I'm missing anything. I want to read a book and get as much enjoyment out of it as I can rather than just read every book in the world. I have plans to be reading a lot more sci-fi, which sometimes takes like a lot more dedication and thought as well as the literary fiction and classics. I want to be able to take the time to do additional reading for the books outside of actually reading the book. And in order to do that, I have to read less books per month because that also requires reading time. I want to get the most out of my reading experience. I don't want to waste time and especially money on books that are 3-star okay books. I don't have time for that. I'm a busy girl. I don't want to be reading things that are 3-star reads. There's nothing wrong with it, but I want to be reading very impactful, important, emotionally evocative books that leave this long-lasting impression on me. And I do think that this change in my reading style will help tremendously with my enjoyment and my ability to read those types of books and not feel like I'm just missing the bigger picture when I do read them. And I guess another example is when I started reading Never Let Me Go by Kazuo Ishiguro in October, I read 18 books that month and it just did not work. But when I picked it back up this month and I was reading so few things, I had time to let it settle with me and I really enjoyed it. So I guess it's like I don't want to speed through a lot of books just to experience all the stories if I'm not loving them. I'm rambling so much at this time and I'm gonna cut this video off because My voice needs it. And you're probably sick of hearing me talk like this. But yeah, let's chat about it in the comments. I'd love to hear what you guys think. I have so much respect for everybody that can read all these books a month. I have friends that read like 30 books a month, and I am so impressed by you. And you keep doing you, keep doing what makes you happiest, and never let anyone make you feel like the way that you read and enjoy books is not right for you, because you know what's best for you. This is just simply what I think will be best for me going forward, and I'm really, really excited about it. I'm excited to have the time to annotate, the time to research, the time to read and relax and enjoy other hobbies and activities and feel less stress and pressure when it comes to my favorite hobby. So let's talk more about it in the comments. Tomorrow is Thanksgiving if you are an American and celebrate. And even if you're not, I'm thankful for all of you guys. I'm so thankful for your support and your love and kindness and comments, because if it's not for you guys, Books with Brittany doesn't exist. You guys make this happen. So I am thankful for each and every one of you. I'm thankful to everyone that comments on any video ever. Well, most of the comments. Thankful for all of you guys, genuine supporters. And I hope that you guys all have a wonderful Thanksgiving with your loved ones, or if you have to be alone for social isolation, I hope that you still can enjoy your day doing solo activities. So let's chat in the comments. Thank you guys for watching, and I will see you next time.